Good evening, ladies and gentlemen of YouTube. This is Zort Rider here, or Rich for those of you that know me. And I have an awful goddamn cold, as you can see by this. It looks like I'm going to be like guiding Santa's sleigh tonight, but it's only March, so I hope it doesn't last until December. But a different haircut, so there you go. I look slightly less receding there, but it's better than it was. I look a little bit younger than I did without the slick back look. I've been away for a couple of weeks. I've been on holiday looking after my son, which didn't allow me much time to do a video. And then I went away in Manchester for a week doing a course on effective change management in a business environment. So that was really good, really interesting. The first time I've done exams since I was probably 16 doing my GCSEs. So yeah, it was a good week. Hotel food and massive king size bed to yourself, but it's all good. It's nice to be home. So it's been a couple of weeks since I saw you last, and I've been looking on Twitter while I was away, and there was this one tweet that stuck out by a young lady, Queen Stodge, I think her name is, on Twitter, and she started to say there's these oversized protector bots, and she posted a picture of them in B&M, the same place as we found those KO Hexatron figures just before Christmas, priced about $9.99. These figures look like oversized protector bots in bright G2 kind of colours. I know they've done oversized ones, metal versions that you can import from Japan, but these are retail UK knockoffs. So I've been looking for them to pop out, and lo and behold, look what happened today. I found a few of them. So I've kept one in the packet for now. I will open it in a second just so I can show you the box. But I also went for Rook. This is the first time rip-off. I've opened Rook up. I'll get into the detail about him in a moment. But essentially, this is what you're looking for. So the $9.99 each or two for 15 quid. I would suggest that you get the two for 15 quid. You may as well. There is a Streetwise version, sorry, which is actually on the side of the box here. So he was in the shop as well, but I left him in order of these two. So you can see from the front, we have transforming robot down the side. Convert cars to robots. Wow, that's a concept that I'm sure we haven't heard of before, but there you go. Ambulance, armored vehicle. There's nothing you need more than an armored ambulance. And it's a medical officer guard rescue. Bit of a long name. I'm not sure that would fit on his birth certificate, but there you go. So the box itself, you've got image of first aid, or this version of first aid here. You've got a fire truck. You've got images on the side of protector bot first aid, or what's it called? Transforming arms and legs, which is always good. You've got Rook there in a really funky shade of green. You've got Streetwise there, and then on the bottom you've got the instructions, if I don't hit myself in the face. On the top, transforming robots. On the bottom, as I say, instructions. And on the back, now this is great, this is amazing. On the back, you've got Defensor. Now you can see that these were the three that are listed on the side, so I'm not expecting the rest of these, but there is seems to be yellow Streetwise here, a hotspot in correct colours, and a groove. So I'm just looking inside of Rook's packaging before I go into the actual robots themselves, and inside you get another nice image of Defensor. I don't know if you can see, I'll move them a little bit closer. It says here, defamation, and it's got pictures of all random dinosaurs on there. Has got some what looks like writing my name, it's just lines. That's really bizarre. What have rescue vehicles got to do with dinosaurs? So here he is, Rook in his alt mode, and it's a big green hulky beast of a toy. Plastic quality doesn't feel that bad at all on the actual toy itself. We've got the foot slash missile launcher slash hand here. This feels a little bit cheap. It doesn't feel as strong as the other plastic. This feels quite sturdy. This bends. This plastic doesn't tend to bend. You can, I don't know if you can see it, but you can squeeze this plastic in. Whereas on this guy, it's not budging. Even the plastic quality on the weapons are pretty solid. That's an additional weapon. There we go. It's an additional weapon that they don't get with the original toy, which is quite an interesting addition. They didn't have to do that. And you do get his hook type weapon as well, which is pretty cool. Size comparison. So here's Combiner Wars Rook, and here's this oversized beast. It's almost leader size, I'd say. Let me just take these accessories off so you can see it properly. So yeah, pretty hefty. Some nice silver paint on the wheels here that you don't even get on the Hasbro version. Some nice silver detail here. The actual paintwork on this thing isn't too bad. The orange looks a little thin and has been discoloured by the green underneath. But you know what? Vehicle mode, I have to give it top marks. This is a pretty good representation of Rook. And will look great as a G2 Autobot or Shattered Glass Autobot, or as a custom. If someone can paint this up and make it look like Rook, that would be pretty good. Top marks in vehicle mode for this thing. So here he is in robot mode. He's a bit of a beast. And this is where it starts to go a little bit wrong for this figure. It has been simplified. The head has a hollow back here, but you know what? It still turns. You know what? Let's be happy for that. The head doesn't sit properly on top of the transformation joint. This joint is not ratcheted at all, which is going to cause a few problems. It's quite tight, but it's going to cause some problems if there is a combined mode, if we do get the rest of them. But the port is there, as I say. This head doesn't sit flush on top. Shadow articulation can go up and back thanks to the transformation. This panel at the back doesn't tab in because there isn't a hole there. It does stay pretty firmly, but it's not the best. The legs don't have a bend at the knee. That's been removed. You can move out and in, but that is essentially it. You can bend the knees outwards like that. This is the worst part. This guy can't even do a Borders Dude pose. That is the articulation on the arms, at the elbow. They do not turn in. They've been oversimplified. The only good pose you can get him to do is a bit of a shrug. So why did you join the Protector Box, Rook? I don't know. It's just silly. How can you have waist articulation, but you can't have, you haven't got articulation in the arms to turn them round the right way? It's such a shame, because this figure looks pretty good. As you can see, let's have a look at the head sculpt. Pretty cool, pretty much spot on like Rook. Paint work is there, even though it's not the best. Let's get some weapons in his hands or whatever. But this is the other point, actually. Is if I remember rightly, and I'll check in a moment when I transform him, these aren't Rook's hands. Doesn't he have the whole fist thing to plug it in? It doesn't look like he can do that on this guy. So this is probably the best pose you'll get with weapons, holding them up in the air, to the side, or down like so. That is basically it. It's such a shame. But you know what? For all his faults, I actually love this thing. I wasn't going to buy the oversized Protector Bots, the metal versions that have been made in Japan. But I'm very tempted now to pick one up, even if it's just a Rook. I've noticed as well, his leg doesn't quite tab him properly. And I'm not going to force it. So he's going to have to stand with a slightly wider stance. Probably be keeping this guy in car mode or in leg mode. So here they are side by side. It is really upscaled, as you can see. To the backs, to the side, bit of a view of the head sculpt. It's such a shame. The plastic quality isn't bad at all. I'll give it a 7 out of 10. It's definitely better than the Hexatron that we had in B&M. It's just a shame it's been oversimplified. It's still a very, very cool thing, but it's full of faults. Shall we open up First Aid and have a look at him? So here is First Aid, or not First Aid. It feels quite sturdy. The plastic quality feels a little bit... little bit thinner in places on this one. Articulation points, we've got knees, people, and we've got elbows, which is pretty brilliant. The arms can do a full 360 on both sides. The legs are on a ball joint and they are forward and back. So articulation wise, this guy isn't that bad at all. Face sculpt, as you can see, is the same as First Aid, but yeah, it's a little bit thinner. You can see I've got a bit of excess plastic here, so that hasn't been trimmed off. I'll drop it down the laptop case, which isn't good. Hands are just normal hold fists. What I've noticed is when the legs click together, can you see how small that clip is? So yeah, they've saved a little bit on plastic there. The head is not on a swivel, which is a little bit disappointing. Let's have a look at him next too. This is Combiner Wars Breakneck. Now, I have got First Aid, but him and Rook were part of my Galvatronus figure. So combined mode, so I thought, well, I might as well use him as the same mold. But you can see, greatly oversized. He does have his axe. He doesn't have an additional weapon, unlike Rook, which is a little bit bizarre. But you can see what these guys look size comparison wise. So here he is in vehicle mode. It does again look probably the better of the two modes. The only problem with this vehicle mode is this front doesn't seem to tab in properly. Don't know if they've removed some parts or whatever, but it doesn't seem to tab in quite flush. But it looks pretty good. It's got some decent sirens on there in a metallic paint, lots of silver, lots of detail down the side. It's pretty cool. There is no place apart from the combiner port on the back to store the axe. But yeah, pretty good detail. Not a bad looking KO, shame about this, but there you go. Let's get Breakneck in again so you can see the sizes. In case you wanted to know, this is what they look like as legs. So you can imagine the size of what this thing's going to be. It's going to be up there with the Jinbao Bruticus that I've got for size. I will get all these if they are all available. Probably not going to buy Streetwise unless they come down in price. But if the two are going for 15 quid, I will pick them up. So for both of these guys, would I recommend them? So, if you like a good KO, and you like a knockoff toy, and you like your oversized stuff, absolutely yes. Rook is an absolutely brilliant vehicle mode. First Aid, this is annoying. It doesn't clip in quite right, but it's a good looking vehicle mode. Robot mode, First Aid is probably the best because of the articulation, whereas with the Rook, his articulation's laughable at best. Would these guys look good in a combined mode? It probably would. Would it hold together very well? I doubt it very much. The pegs on the feet are very, very small. They feel loose already. And the lack of ratchets on the combiner ports would probably mean that this would fall apart, but it probably would look pretty awesome. So thanks again, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll try and do another one soon. I have got a G1 Fangry on the way, which I managed to pick up really cheap, which is great. I haven't got any more robots planned to buy, to be honest with you. I think that I've kind of stepped away a little bit from the third party market because the market's completely saturated now. It was great before when we were getting masterpiece representations of some characters, like, for example, I don't know, Blitzwing, the DX9 version, or the Galvatron from DX9, but there's just three or four different versions of the same figure. And it just feels so saturated at the moment, and they're a lot of money. And I'm not having to dig at people who collect third party at all, because you know what? Fair play to you. They're amazing toys to look at. And I own a few of them myself. But at this moment in time, there's so much out there and they're so expensive. I'm getting more enjoyment out of things that I stumble across in the shops. I mean, for example, I know I talked about this guy in my previous video, but I've played with this thing more than I have some of my third party Transformers that I paid 70 odd quid for, and I spent 6 quid on this. So another reason is I am planning to move house, so the more I acquire, the more I have to pack away, and that's going to be a pain in the arse, basically. So I have toned down a little bit. I did manage to pick up this little dude, which is Thunderwing. Now, you might have remembered from a previous video I did, I acquired an old Thunderwing. I've touched up the paintwork on it and it looks pretty good now. I needed the inner robot. These are going for about 30 or 40 quid on eBay, and I managed to buy a lot with this dude in there and another 17 Autobots, mini cars, and some GoBots and that. So this guy arrived. I picked another couple of robots that I decided to keep, a G1 Power Glide because it was in better condition than my original Power Glide, and two Legends figures, the little G2 Tank Megatron and a Bumblebee, and I managed to sell them on the same day for 30 quid. So this guy and another three bots cost me about 8 quid in total, which isn't too bad when this guy's up there for 40 quid. The only downside is it has got some discoloration, but you know what? I don't really care about that. I think G1 toys are meant to look a little bit worn and play with, and I'm going to get some new stickers for this. So that's my cool little doing up project. But when it comes to third party, and I might pick up a few more of the knockoffs because they're relatively cheap, but I can't see me investing in an expensive third party figure until probably Transformers Nation. The only one that really is sticking in my mind at the moment that I really want to step into is the Toy World Cosmos. Junk Heap Dave, good friend of mine, has got one. I've seen the photos of it and it looks great. It looks chunky. It's got its flaws, but you know, it looks a great figure to have, and it's not that badly priced. But we're going to have two Cosmoses. This is what I'm about flooding the market. You invest in this expensive toy just to see one come out another couple of weeks later. You think, have I bought the right one? Never mind. But I'm enjoying the first party ones, and I'm enjoying the Hasbro official ones that are in the shops. Which reminds me, before I go, and I am waffling on a bit here, in B&M as well, they have had these guys in, which are the robots in disguise. They're kind of between Legends and Warrior class figures with the armour, and they come with a minicon. So they have Sideswipe, Grimlock, Prime and Bumblebee in there. I think it's wave 1 and 2 of these figures. They're priced at $7.99 each. But I managed to get this at $5.99 because they had the wrong price on the shelf. So I've actually got all four of them that they had in stock, which is pretty cool. The cool thing is the minicons are pretty cool. So if you're into your RID, get yourself down to B&M. If you're into your KOs and your knockoff toys, get yourself down to B&M. And I've waffled on for far too long now, so I hope you enjoyed this video. And hopefully it won't be another 2 weeks before I do the next one. So I'll speak to you soon.